Here we go. Everything was going very smoothly at the start. Then we were presented with the menu, a la carte. Printed at the top, Nouvelle Cuisine was proudly stated. They bought the brand new kitchen, I triumphantly translated. We started with hors d'oeuvres and me girlfriend chose the plate, while I picked avocado vinaigrette. It sounded quite appealing, but we had a funny feeling that this meal would be one we would regret. It was a little bit of nothing on a big white plate. The portions were so tiny and my appetite so great. In anticipation, I'd a mouthful of saliva, but my plate looked quite as naked as the legendary Godiva. I asked for some bread rolls, I thought they'd help to fill the gaps. The waiter offered brioche, no, I said I want some baps. So much for the starter, better luck with the entree. It wasn't very long before they took the plates away. This was certainly a meal that would help you lose some weight. It was a little bit of nothing on a big white plate. The waiting between courses I thought would never end. I couldn't see what Egon Ronay found to recommend. I fiddled with the candles till my fingers had been scalded and tried to figure out how all those napkins had been folded. We looked towards the kitchen as the door began to swing. At last our wish was coming true. But then we saw the dishes, or no answer to our wishes. Just an all-consuming sense of déjà vu. It was a little bit of nothing on a big white plate. It took a long time coming and it wasn't worth the wait. Laid out there before us by those garlic-scented waiters with their designer gravy and those arty-farty taters. The peas looked anorexic and those lazy little sods hadn't shelled them, so we had to eat the blighters in their pots. Then at last, we spotted it, the beef medallion. So small, I don't suppose the cow had noticed it had gone. This was certainly not the meal that was going to satiate. It was a little bit of nothing on a big white plate. When it came to pudding, it did very little good in inquiring after roly-poly spotted dick. And in a way, we got a bit disheartened when we asked for treacle tart, and all the waiter had to offer was some trifling sorbet. The tiny cups of coffee came, it must have been a joke, and yet the waiter wasn't what you would have called a funny bloke. No prizes now for guessing how they served the after eights. But they must have had a bloody lot of big white plates. Everyone was feeling peckish still. But the only thing the waiter had to bring us was the bill. It was the biggest thing all eating on a big white plate. How on earth he reached the total I could never calculate. The service charge and extras had me well and truly beaten, for the bill bore no relation to the food that we had eaten. We rummaged through our pockets where we dug so deep to find the sort of figure that would make Georgie Osborne weep. We stormed out of the restaurant and we didn't leave no tips, cause we had to keep a change to go and buy some fish and chips. So, fellas, if you want to take your girlfriend on a date, you should do yourself a favour, go for quantity, not flavour, cause you never get enough in if the restaurant is bluffing with a little bit of nothing on a big